Often stress affects your digestion. It can give you stomach aches. It can give you acid reflux. It can make all these things worse. It can give you bloating. It can give you intestinal discomfort, a poor food digestion, poor food breakdown. So stress can really harm even a function as important as digestion. Praying, which is the number one thing to do. And then number two, learning better eating habits, not eating big, huge meals late at night, learning how to eat in a more relaxed way, and eating foods that don't stress your body, not too much sugar, not too much saturated fat, not too much acidic foods, too much foods that are highly vinegared, sharp kind of sauces that are harder to digest, deep fried food. I mean, the list is endless. Will also put stress on your body, and along with the stress that you're already feeling, the two together can be a disaster for your digestion. So these are just a couple of issues. These are the things that I see all the time, and I'm constantly working with people to work with this. In terms of dealing with stress, we need to keep our stress-dealing parts of our body really strong and really healthy. Because when you're under a lot of chronic stress, you're going to be at much higher risk of cancer and heart disease and strokes, high blood pressure and headaches and sore backs and sore necks and inflammation and rashes and all kinds of stuff. The more stress we have that's prolonged, the more it depletes our ability to manage it because we weaken ourselves. The more stress we have, the more you have to mount a stress reaction, and the poor brain and the nervous system and the endocrine system, which are some of the main parts that have to deal with this, and even every cell in your body just gets more weak and more tired from, oh, more stress and more stress. So we need to build these things up and keep them nice and strong. So it's important to be aware that there's a lot of things that you can even do in the nutritional area that are very helpful in terms of building you up and reducing inflammation and kind of a good, I won't say preventive program because people are already having the stress and having the issues, but it's important to be aware of this. For example, one of our big stress vitamins is the whole B vitamin family. There's 10 B vitamins, and they're very important in balancing the brain and the heart, reproductive function. For example, women's menstrual cycles depend on this. Your liver's ability to break down, metabolize waste products, chemicals in your body, even your hormones, your thyroid hormone, your insulin, chemicals from the environment are metabolized by the liver. And the liver, we found years ago, like 70 years ago, that the liver needs some of the B vitamins in order to be able to do its job. Without the B vitamins, the liver can't do it. So again, we see this all over the body. Look at all the examples I've been giving you of how much we depend on just B vitamins to help keep us balanced and to help us handle virtually any kind of stress. And most importantly, so that our precious organs and tissues and cells that are a gift from God can function well. So this is really, really important. For example, we make chemicals in the brain called neurotransmitters, and we have neurotransmitters that speed us up and help us charge when we are stressed, kind of that fight and flight syndrome where you go into stress mode, your muscles tense and you tighten up and you get ready to run when the lion's going to chase you. You know, it's kind of the example that we give, but you got to head out of traffic or you got to make a meeting or whatever. These are the excitatory chemicals that charge you up. And then we have those wonderful inhibitory chemicals in the brain and throughout the body that quiet you down and relax you. When we're all stressed out, we have too much of the charge chemicals and too little often of the relax, where you're mellow and you're peaceful. Because you can be really active and really getting a lot of stuff done and exercising and climbing mountains and biking and getting your to-do list done, but you can do it in a strong, powerful, vital, but relaxed way. And again, it's that balance that does it, and the B vitamins are crucial. For example, vitamin B12, vitamin B6, these are vitamins that are really important to make these crucial kinds of brain chemicals. Your adrenal gland supports the same kind of chemical balance because your adrenal runs on some of the same chemicals that the brain and nervous system produce, the charge-up chemicals. It's very important that that we have healthy adrenals. And same thing, the B vitamins are very important for the adrenals because they help to produce these chemicals in a very balanced, healthy way. For example, vitamin B12 is really important for your mood. It helps to balance you in terms of giving you a lot of energy and also helping you so you don't get real anxious and uptight and worried and don't get depressed. B6 is awesome because it helps to balance your mood and your stress as it relates to your hormones. I mean, we are amazing works of God. He's created us in the most incredible way, more than you can ever imagine. And pantothenic acid, which is vitamin B5, is needed for healthy adrenals. So the B vitamins are everywhere. Choline is another one that's needed for the brain so that you make acetylcholine, which is a super important brain hormone so that you're healthy, but you're sharp mentally. You're not walking around and, you know, with a lot of fog. You're clear and you're sharp, but you can also be relaxed and peaceful and balanced. It also helps to regulate your blood lipids, which when they're high can put you at risk of heart attack. Choline is good for your brain, it's good for your heart, it's good for your liver. It's a fat emulsifier when it comes from lecithin, which is a food substance. So the B vitamins are really important for handling stress, as is magnesium, which acts as a natural relaxant, and as is potassium and calcium, which with magnesium helps you to sleep better at night. I mean, these nutrients are incredibly important. Fish oil, like what we find in salmon and tuna and mackerel, or in a supplement because of the EPA and the DHA, it actually is crucial for balancing your mood. It's important for preventing bipolar, where you can flip around from too much uptight to depressed to mania to depression. So you're just kind of flipping around all the time. And fish oil is really important for helping to balance that. The omega-3 fatty acid fish oil in particular, you can also get it from algae, from vegetarian sources. You can get it from krill. So it's a really important nutrient created by God. It really helps to keep us unstressed and helps to balance us along with the wonderful vitamins. Vitamin C is another really common vitamin. It's in all the multis, at least you get a little bit. But it does boost our immune system, it strengthens the adrenals, and it helps to prevent stress from making us sick, from giving us even common stuff like colds and flus and allergic reactions. It's an important nutrient to have, both in terms of the food that we eat. You know, like high vitamin C content food is very good to be taking in the diet. We find that a lot in fruits, for example. It's a really good nutrient. And also as a supplement, a good amount, 500 milligrams would be like an absolute basic level, but 1,000 milligrams a day, which you can get in one or two capsules or lozenges, are great. And you can go up to 2 or 3 or 4 grams a day. There's even cancer protocols now that give vitamin C IV at very high doses. When you take these things at high doses, sometimes they're really helpful just in terms of curing disease, period. There's a lot of nutrients that you can take that are also not vitamin, mineral, but botanical. For example, herbal medicine, a lot of people really feel really well when they do use herbs, not just to flavor food and make food taste good, but to use it as a healing supplement. For example, relaxant herbs that help you deal with stress are really common ones, like that nice cup of chamomile tea. That's a relaxant herb. If you have a lot of physical stress, like tight muscles and abdominal cramping or tense muscles, locked up muscles, nice simple herb like potassium is a wonderful, we call it an antispasmodic in the medical field. These are great herbs. They balance you. They make you feel good. Passiflora is a really good one if stress is keeping you from sleeping well at night. Passiflora, valerian root, a cup of chamomile that I just mentioned before going to sleep at night is wonderful. So herbs are a real blessing for people. A lot of people like to take herbs. A lot of illnesses we don't cure, we treat you to try to bring the symptoms under control, but to totally get rid of illness, that's God. And so praying is just one of the most important things that we can do. I really recommend that everybody bring prayer into their life because we can literally call on God to pray for everything and to put ourselves into a much more peaceful, wonderful place and not be at such high risk of illness. Very important to engage in prayer, read the word, read the Bible. There's so much good in there, and God is really our best way to deal with stress and to bring ourselves into joy. And God says that in the Bible. Number one, he wants us to love. Love God, love thy neighbor as thyself. Number one, number two commandments. But he wants us also to be in joy. Upset is not of God, that's of the enemy. The enemy wants you to be miserable and stressed out and having a really difficult life, where God wants you to have a blessed, beautiful, happy life, full of joy, full of happiness. Just remember, a merry heart is the best medicine. It's right in the Bible. And God talks many times about the importance of being joyful and all the good things even that come with love. Love is patient. Love is kind. Love doesn't keep a record of wrongs. This is the way God created us to be, to have an ability to handle stress so it becomes much littler instead of taking over your life.